afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is October 9th. It is Thursday, and today we're going to answer your health questions. We're going to run through a bunch of them here. There's a lot of great questions. I'm so glad that you guys posted questions the last time I asked. Again, at any time, if you do have questions, please post them on the blog, post them on Facebook, post them on YouTube, anywhere, and we will get to them. Now, again, I don't know everything. I'm humble enough to know that I can't possibly know everything. So if I don't know it, what I tend to do is I have Lisa, who's our amazing assistant, I have her go out and find someone who can answer those questions. Or actually, I find the person, then I have her go contact them. And then I provide them as a Wednesday night series interview. So that's really the best way to do it for me because, hey, I want to learn too. And there were two people who asked about polycystic ovarian syndrome. I know nothing about that. So what we're going to do for you two out there, and I'm sure that there's a few more, what we're going to do is we're going to find someone who is really an expert in that, and then we'll have them talk about it instead of me trying to figure out, you know, or getting a couple books and reading through them and then spitting that information back to you. So I hope that you guys enjoy that because that's what I want to do for you. So just two things before we get into the show. The first thing is for those people who listen to the David Wolf call, last night, I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to post that link down below for those who want to listen to it again. For some people who were disappointed that we talked about Elements for Life, which is a multi-level marketing company, for a little bit, I apologize for that. But I really feel that we want to help spread the word of that product and that product line. So we know we do need to actually promote something every once in a while. And for those people who are disappointed that we actually promote something, we have 157 episodes for absolutely free. So for what it's worth, enjoy those. And, you know, just, hey, you know, take it with a grain of salt, right? So let's get into your questions. Faye asks, oh, and before I even get to that, thank you so much for your comments about the intro to the show. We are going to go with number one, but we're going to change it with a bunch of your suggestions. So thank you for providing that. I really am excited that you guys rallied. We had over 100 posts, 100 suggestions. I had Nicole, our designer, Nicole at NB Creative, and our designer go through and look at all the comments. And she came back and said, wow, this is just a lot. And I said, well, let's just work through the ones and really make it work. So we came up with something pretty good today. So you guys will see that. No, give it a couple weeks. We need to finish it up and make sure everything's good. So let's get into your questions. Faye asks, I have a question. Just started a new fitness routine with a personal trainer. Keen to increase muscle mass and tone up, but my muscles get quickly tired during workouts. My trainer recommends a whey drink, but I was wondering what food drinks you recommend to eat before and after working out. Well, I already answered this question on a workout, on one of the Fitness Fridays, but because your muscles get tired during a workout doesn't necessarily mean that you're lacking protein. You know, if you just started working with a personal trainer, that could simply just mean that your muscles aren't used to creating the energy they need to actually generate the strength that you need to do the exercises. So, for instance, when your muscles are lax for a long period of time, what happens is that your cells, the muscle cells, they release some of the mitochondria that are in your cells. And so that's just kind of your body just streamlining for non-activity. But when you activate yourself again, what happens is that your body creates more mitochondria inside of those muscle cells. And so when you start to move again, sometimes you're tired because your mitochondria aren't there to produce the ATP, which actually gets everything going. So, yes, you can also get, you know, you can get better recovery from amino acids. And now, I'm not a big fan of whey protein for a few reasons, but I do like a rice protein. I do like Sun Warrior protein, but you can find other brown rice proteins. And I like that because the assays, the protein assays, are very similar to that of whey and to egg protein. So if you can get the same amount of amino acids in a plant base, then why bother with the animal product? And that's kind of what I feel. So I'll give you a link to Sun Warrior down below, but I hope that helps. Claudia asks, is it safe for my 3-month-old breastfeeding baby if I do any kind of cleansing? I'm going to say no. I'm going to say this is not a good time to cleanse. I would also say that if you decide to take any supplements, please go to your healthcare practitioner and show them exactly what you're taking just to make sure that everything is cool. So Claudia, I hope that helps. I know you had some other breastfeeding questions on the blog, and I think some of the other readers already answered them. So thank you guys out there for being a team and helping support everyone else. Let's see. Louise asks, Kevin, have you ever used those green bags to store your veggies and fruits in? And if you have, what is your opinion? Hold on a second. Let me go get one. All right, so here's the green bag that Louise was talking about. And what it does, it's slightly porous, so it releases the gases as the vegetables actually oxidize. So it doesn't hold the gases in to help, you know, so the vegetables don't actually decompose inside the bag. Now, this has been in our fridge for a couple days, but this bok choy looks fairly healthy. Now, obviously, nothing replaces, you know, fresh, locally grown vegetables. But if you are going to keep your vegetables in the fridge for a while, this is actually a pretty good way to do it. Oh. All right, so Melissa asked, what is your opinion on Dr. Douglas Graham and his 80-10-10 in regards to fat, insulin, and candida? Here's the deal. When you're switching into any diet, you have to keep in mind your past. You have to keep in mind what you've had before when you jump into this new thing. So for instance, if you have a small amount of candida in your body and you start piling on the fruit, what's going to happen, regardless of whether there's a fat or a sugar balance, regardless of that, your candida is going to eat the sugar and it's going to grow and it's going to become a big colony in your system. So I suggest, my own personal opinion is that if you're going to transition over into that something, do it very, very slowly so you can have some time to adjust so your body doesn't go completely out of whack. I believe that the reason that I broke out with acne is because I switched over way too fast. I went from eating a lot of greens and a lot of cooked grains to a lot of fruit. And I think that really just kind of, you know, shot up the incidence of candida in my system. And now I'm working to kind of build that down again and, you know, kind of create a nice homeostasis inside of my gut. And then I'm going to be able to reintroduce fruit and find out my best, the diet that's best for me. I'm still working on it. It's been 10 years in the making. But that's okay. I'm cool with that, and I enjoy every single minute of it. So your question of the day is this: in regards to some of the emails we got about the David Wolf call and people not happy about us actually promoting something, go ahead down below and post and say, what's an acceptable promotion? How about that? That's a good question. What's acceptable to you? What makes sense? What makes you happy? Say, hey, this is cool. Take it or leave it kind of thing. So this is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.